In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, sisters, and welcome this morning to the celebration of Holy Mass, this Mass of Requiem for the repose of the soul of Benny. To Rosemary, to Bernard, Lisa, and to Anthony, we offer your prayers in this morning, our condolences, and our sympathy. We come as the family of God to pray for the happy repose of the soul of Benny. You are warmly welcome to this celebration. We begin, as always, by renewing our sorrow for our faults and failings, remembering our God as the Father quick to forgive and gently wipe our tears away. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, Bernard, your servant, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Please sit down.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster. They're leaving us like an annihilation. But they are in peace. If they experience punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction. Great will be their blessing. God has put them to the test and proven them to be worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love. For grace and mercy await those he has chosen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Be ambitious for higher gifts, and I am going to show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offence and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Seeing the crowds, Jesus went up the hill. There he sat down and was joined by his disciples. Then he began to speak, and this is what he taught them. How happy are the poor in spirit. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy the gentle. They shall have the earth for their heritage. Happy those who mourn. They shall be comforted. Happy those who hunger and thirst for what is right. They shall be satisfied. Happy the merciful. They shall have mercy shown them. Happy the pure in heart. They shall see God. Happy the peacemakers. They shall be called children of God. Happy those who are persecuted in the cause of right. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy are you when people abuse you and persecute you, and speak all kinds of calumny against you on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Please sit down for a few minutes. Love is always patient and kind. It is never rude nor resentful, and it excuses whatever wrongs that may happen. The readings of this morning's Mass are very beautiful. The reading of this morning's Gospel was taken from the Sermon on the Mount. It is there that Jesus of Nazareth told his disciples how to live and how to be builders of his kingdom here on earth. A kingdom where people work for justice and peace, where they try to do right, where they hunger and thirst for what is good, and those who are pushed to the margins of society are seen as beautiful in the eyes of God. The lame, the blind, those who cannot talk nor hear, the people who are shoved to the edges, and people who are thought worthless by the world. Love is always patient and kind. But love is useless if it's merely a concept and an abstract thing that people sit talking about round a table. Love has got to be put into action by the things that we do, the practical, humdrum, workaday things that we do well and do well for others. It is in action that our love is most concrete. Today in Lent, where yesterday we read the Passion, and again we took part and entered into that awful, terrible torment that Jesus of Nazareth went through. On that Sunday, they ushered him into Jerusalem with palms, hence the palms that are at either end of the altar and on the floor. But the relics of the church in form of statues or crucifix is veiled because we are entering into a period of mourning and sadness. That great hosanna of Jesus going in on a donkey to Jerusalem is quickly changed when we approach Friday and they are shouting, "Crucify him, crucify him." It's important to remember that Jesus suffered silently. He never uttered a word. And in that suffering and in that silence, he offered it for you and I, that we may enjoy the freedom of the children of God. And it is a child of God that we come to pray for this morning. Bernard Lynch, oldest child of Margaret McGowan and Hughie. He was born at Uddingston and then they emigrated, the family, to View Park. 10 of them, which means it was a bigger house. Benny went to St. John's Primary School and then on to St. Catherine's. And after school, he went to work in Piri's the Butcher in Uddingston. He went to night school and did his city in guilds, so he would become a master butcher, which was a great trade. It was cold. It meant working in very cold conditions. But he could talk to people and serve them as he is giving out the butcher meat. And above all, Benny loved people. He loved to listen and he loved to talk. After the butchers, he went to Caterpillar in maintenance distribution until the strikes, of course. Caterpillar, being that company of American descent that did not have unions. He then went to the Bearing Service Company, which became then Bramner. Benny worked all his adult life, providing food for the table and nurturing his family. Rosemary Henderson worked in Pillars of Perth, next door to the butchers. That is Benny's first job. There was a chap in the butchers who was going to ask Rosemary out, and of course he was bumming and blethering about it in the shop, whereas Benny went in and asked her out first. Something that he lived a long time not to regret. They were married in 1965 and the celebrant at the wedding at Holy Family in Moss End was Father Docherty. The great thing that Rosemary remembers from the wedding wasn't who was there or what the wedding breakfast was like, nor indeed if she was absolutely beautiful in her wedding attire. She remembers as they were kneeling for a blessing that Benny's shoes were particularly shiny and well polished. Indeed, they must have been brand new because on the bottom there was a tab on the heel that said £2.19.11. The sow forgot to take them off before he got married. Of course, then the family grew and the family were blessed And in very posh books, they said the issue from the marriage was the three cherubs that are sitting down the front, Bernard, Lisa and Anthony, the delight of their parents' eyes. It was a very happy marriage, probably because Benny was a good listener, and probably because they gave and take, one would give and one would take. But the two boys and the only daughter were raised in a very loving family household, where love was very prevalent, where they could talk, they could listen, they could cry, and they could laugh. And that's what family really is essentially about. And of course, it was a faith-filled family, exactly the same kind of families that Benny and Rosemary came from. They passed that on to their children with God's good grace. Declan, Jamie Lee, Chloe and Ben are the grandchildren. Jane, Sophie and Mia are the great-grandchildren. In the last few years of Benny's life, he had many interests, particularly an interest in a football club that has its ground in the East End of Glasgow. But he also had other interests which included the family. He did suffer in the last few years, and there is no denying that fact. It was my privilege to attend him with Holy Communion and to hear his confession nearly since the time of the day I came here. For me as a person, it was a great joy to attend Benny. He always had an interest in the priest. He would talk about everyday things, whether it would be the state of the economy, the state of the government, or the state of the Scottish Parliament in Edinburgh. He was interested in everything that went on. And when I asked him how he was, he would always say, "I'm fine. I'm absolutely fine. I'm okay." I never, ever heard him complain. And the things that he suffered from in his feet and then in his legs must have caused him complete and utter pain. That house was a house where love was lived practically. His wife and children cared for him in the ordinary tasks that wives and children should do. And they were exemplary in doing that. It wasn't without rows and arguments, because that's the stuff of which we are made. But Benny was safe. He knew he was loved, and he was helped in that environment. What better way to prepare to meet your Maker? Benny Lynch was a good man. He had a heart of corn. He was very much a revered member of this community by doing the tasks that no one would know about. He was never in the limelight and never shouted from the hilltops. I wish we had more parishioners like Benny Lynch in this community of St. Bride's. His suffering is now over, even although Rosemary was saying novenas to different saints, and oftentimes she would get the saint mixed up in the window ledge. Rosemary, it was St. Francis of Assisi and not St. Anthony. And the other thing was, hand was always off the statue. Or she went in the next time, maybe her foot would be off. But nevertheless, the intention was there. Prayers were said. Love was given and shared. Today, all the good that was Benny Lynch, I am sure, is being rewarded. And he will help you, his sons and daughter and wife, as the days go on. You will miss him tremendously, but he will be with you in prayer and ways that you do not know. You had a father grandfather and great-grandfather beyond compare. He was a man who was quiet, who was good, who loved you and loved those round about us. But more importantly, he loved God, and he certainly loved Rosemary, who was so kind and good at serving. We pray that Benny may be enjoying eternal rest and eternal peace. Eternal rest, grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. May his soul, and the souls of all the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us stand to pray. Father, we come before you as your children, and we come before you with the needs of our world, a world in which Benny Lynch often questioned and prayed for. We pray in particular for the peoples of Palestine, that peace and justice may come to that area, and that children may be helped and consoled. Lord, hear us. We pray for those who are sick and those who are housebound with no one to look after them. We ask you, Lord, to soothe them, help and console them. Lord, hear us. We pray for all the people who came to Benny and Rosemary's home to look after Benny. We remember the carers, the district nurses, the staff of Herr Myers, and the home team. We ask you, Lord, to bless their hands and their hearts in their vocation to care, to love, and to serve. Lord, hear us. We pray for Benny's family. May they be consoled at this time. May their faith be strengthened and their hope secure. Lord, hear us. Quietly we bring before God our own prayers and thoughts and intentions. Mother of Jesus, we ask you to spread your mantle upon Benny's family. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen. Father, in your kindness hear the prayers of your children, and in your graciousness and tenderness answer them as you see fit. We ask this and all these through Christ our Lord. Please sit down now for the offertory.
I am with you. might sing. Gifts of bread and wine, my soul.
Please stand. Pray, my friends, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these offerings, Lord, and this, for the salvation of Benny, your servant, we ask your mercy that he did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour. May he find in him a merciful friend. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father, through your beloved Son, Jesus our Lord, the Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, born of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will, and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands, enduring the passion and breaking the bonds of death. And so we join the angels, the archangels and saints in this song of joy. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please sit or kneel. Lord, you are holy indeed, the fountain of all holiness. Let your Spirit come upon these gifts of bread and wine, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and serve you. We pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring us to the fullness of charity, together with your servants Francis, Joseph, our bishop, and all your people. Remember your servant Bernard, whom you have called to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son on earth, be also one with him in the joy of the resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your presence. Have mercy on all of us. Make us worthy to share life eternal with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, Joseph, her husband, the apostles, Saint Bernard of Clairvaux, and all saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. Together we stand. And with one voice and with one heart, we pray for the coming of God's kingdom. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord, deliver us from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but rather on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's share that peace with each other. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy. You should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. To you who are joining us from a distance, you are warmly welcome to this Holy Mass. Please take part in the celebration by opening your hearts to receive Holy Communion by desire. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. For those who cannot go to Holy Communion for any reason this morning, and you wish to receive a blessing, please approach me and put your hand to your shoulder like so. Thank you.
Oh,
Please stand. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, Benny, our brother, may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Thank you for your prayerful presence here this morning, which is a great sign of support and solidarity for Benny's family. Please keep them in your prayers in the days and in the weeks ahead. Thank you to those who took part, in a particular way to our readers, to Marie and to Hugh for enhancing this morning's liturgy with sacred music and song. We come to our prayers now of farewell and commendation. As these prayers are said and sung, Benny's coffin is blessed with water, which reminds us of Benny's baptism long ago. Then Benny's coffin will be incensed, as the fragrance of that incense arises to the roof of this church. It represents the fragrance of our prayers arising to the God who made us and takes us back to his compassionate heart. The cortege, after the final prayers, will go to Bothwell Hall Cemetery. Thank you for your presence here this morning.
Trusting in God and the place where the prayer of the now to come to the last day. There is, of course, sadness in that, but we take comfort to the hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his love and pleasure. Hello, this congregation of the spirits and sacraments, the mercy of God, will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdoms. Therefore, let us console each other with faith in Jesus.
When an artist comes to welcome you and take you to the Holy City,
renewed and eternal to us. Eternal death, my answer to the Lord, and may the perfection of our shame be the excuse. And in this soul, the soul of all faith and heart, we rest in the Lord, the excuse. Let's see there, in space, all.